Alone in the house. It's been 3 weeks. It's been 3 weeks. Maggie.
I am procrastinating about this painting that I'm working on. You will probably have seen it already. Because I don't want to do it. When I spend too much time thinking about paintings that I want to or I have to do, because this is for some kind of show thing, I don't want to do them anymore, because the idea is used up. I like doing things immediately and fast before I get bored of it. And I spent all this time doing maps with this stuff, the masking fluid. And these two purple squares are not supposed to be here because I was supposed to mask first, so I'm really, really annoyed by that. But I don't think it'll be affecting the final result, so whatever. What else? And today I'm supposed to go to Purolator to pick up one of the parcels. Even though I ordered two different kinds of paints at two different times, I think because of the holidays, they're really only one business day apart from each other. So I got the message on Friday to pick it up. So I bet you that when I go to pick it up today, they will try to deliver the second one and then leave me another slip, and then I will have to go to Purolator again tomorrow. So part of me wonders if I should just wait. But another part of me does not want to wait, so I'm just gonna go pick up the parcel. I am not gonna wait for the second one. Forget that. I want it now! I'm assuming it's the gouache because I ordered it first, but you'll never know. Okay, so now that I've started this intimidating sketchbook, I'm starting to get into the groove of it. So, before I would normally go front to back, crinkle, crinkle, and just adjust what I'm using to the paper, which didn't really go well on this page because this cardstock type drawing paper does not watercolor very well at all. Like, there's no color, and it makes really hard edges. You can't blend on it. It's very frustrating. So I mostly just made a mess of it, as one does. And so now that I know that, I won't watercolor anymore. So now that what I've been doing is I've just been kind of flipping through and picking out pages that I want to use. Because this paper here, apparently it's Somerset, does watercolor beautifully. So it has some really nice mixing going on here. Okay. So that one's good. And then I have stuff in the back here. So like a lot of sketching goes on the vellum. Vellum's very nice for that. Pencil sketching, pen sketching, whatever. And yeah. Luckily there's quite a bit of vellum, and I do quite a bit of random garbage sketching, so no problem so far. I also have random stuff to just put in. I guess this is another piece of cardstock that I should not watercolor on. Remember me, because I got this Yupo that I could use instead. And yeah, I think I might have a sketchbook like this in the shop, but I'm not sure. These ones tend to be less popular for some reason, even though, I don't know, it's pretty adventurous. So it always kind of surprises me when nobody wants to try it, but it's kind of fun. It's kind of fun. Ooh, yes, the only downside to just flipping around is that if I draw something in pen, I might end up transferring stuff that I didn't know was there. Like this pencil got on this, and I might end up smudging things. It's a possibility, so I have to be careful about that. You could fix that by just putting a piece of card under what you're drawing, but I might forget, you know? Ooh, I thought this was looking a little bit vibrant, so I just sprayed it with some of this Fet Fabio stuff. It usually doesn't work this well. So that's a surprise. I didn't even film it because surely it's just going to get a nice little light mist. But no, it looks really, looks kind of intense there. Whoop. It's kind of low. I guess it all just sunk to the bottom. Anyway, so I got this. This is a, pretty sure it's my gouache. Could there be any more tape? I've opened this upside down. Oh yeah. Damn. Okay, all right. I mean, okay, like the graphics on the container aren't really that interesting. Then I got the Japanese colors. Ooh. I thought it'd be nice to get some clean color mixes and then some dirty color mixes. Yeah. It also means that I have two tubes of white, which will be very nice. Very nice. Very nice.
Important electronics, everything else you have. Thank you, Tracker. And lastly, we have a new sponsor, guys. It is Quip. Busy electric toothbrush that looks like it was designed by Apple. It is so clean looking, but it also makes your teeth clean looking.
And it's affordable.
And it's affordable, guys. It's really dope, okay?
I could put clouds to sort of tone down the background a little bit. But it's still, I don't know if that would really help, because I still don't have a whole lot of contrast going on, which I think is kind of important. I don't really want to do a color overlay on the background because it doesn't really work that well. I already tried that in the sketchbook because I was playing around. Where the heck? So if I do an overlay, I lose almost all of my work that I put into. So I don't really want to cool down the background this way. Good boy. Aww. I was cleaning up and I had this container in the giveaway book because it had a little bit of picture hanging stuff that I don't use, like the kind that they always come with those little metal hooks that you put the nail through. I've never used one of those in my life, so I don't know what they're for. And I was like, I can't give a giant box away of those. No one wants them. But because the palette did so well, wherever that is. I ripped out the plastic pieces in here. It was like this. And it had spaces to put hanging stuff. And there's this really long one, and I thought, you know, that's actually really kind of cool, because if I had used this to make the watercolor palette with the polymer clay, I would have the pretty clay part here, and then you'd have this cool spot here for maybe tubes or paintbrushes or like little, well, I can find it right now, but like little containers of water even. And although this little piece here would be tricky, I think it would be kind of neat to try it, especially since that last video I made the palette inside the metal tin, which is very simple. And I did say that if I had a plastic one, I would probably try making it outside, bake it, and then try to glue it in. There's a few reasons why I'm not super keen. I'm kind of keen, but I'm not super keen just because I don't. I just bought a bunch of paints. I still have paints coming to me. So I would have to buy more polymer clay, which I'm not terribly. Of course I'm enthusiastic about it, but you know what I mean? Like, I don't want to buy more. I don't want to go to Michael's again. I don't want to buy more clay. And it also means I would have to maybe use enamel paint. Also, this container isn't terribly, like, it looks kind of weird. It's kind of bent. And this thing is sort of, I don't know. It's not great. I don't know why this is so bent. And I can't just rip it off because it wouldn't stay shut without it. It's weirdly just barely functional, and I've been trying to think of ways to replace that with something sensible. It would be perfect. I kind of just want to make one for fun, and I don't know what I would do with it afterward. It would just sit here. I'm a mess. Ugh, the problem with getting a bunch of dried up tubes is when you get a good one, you end up globbing it all over and wasting it. Jeez. So I'm testing these. Spoiler. I'm trying some acrylic wash, and not half of them, which is good. Some of these are still pretty dry, but some of these are completely dried. Alright. Look at this. Like, look at that. I am squeezing so hard. And I was really excited about violet too. I'm really annoyed, especially since both of the blues are also messed up. They are not dried like this. It comes out, these are acrylic paints, so acrylic paint dries plastics. I don't want to spoil this so much, but it's like, what is that? What is that? What is it? What? I don't even know where my paintbrush is. Don't even know. Okay. Like, what are you? What are you? I can get some blue out of it. This is a nice green, but that's about it. Like, this is so frustrating. Because, look at, now I've got little bits of dried up plastic in my paint. That's so good. It's not anybody's fault these things happen. Maybe it's just really old paint. Judging by some of the other colors, like the brown is quite nice, so I'm guessing that the paint itself is fine. It's just a bad batch, which really sucks. Really sucks. It's pretty opaque. I mean, it's nice. It's nice. I just, what is this gross disaster?
You good? Rude.